The Jimmy Z Show.
I just feel nauseous, literally nauseous.
Hi, everybody.
Jimmy Z.
Buddy, Jimmy Z here. I'm going to yammer just a bit about the police shooting of Michael Brown in St. Louis. Well, it's a suburb of St. Louis. I forget the name of the town. It really doesn't matter. But the police shot this 18-year-old boy after a scuffle. There were two, and the way I understand it, and I admit that I am looking at this from a limited position, because what I'm going to talk about is the looting and carrying on by the supposed protesters, not the shooting. But I will say that there's a question about the shooting. It could be that the shooting was unjustified, that the police were not at risk at that moment. But every time you get into a scuffle with police, every time you go for... Now, this is the story that I've heard. And again, all of the details are going to come out in time. We really don't know the whole story. But it appears as though there was a scuffle in the police car. One of these two clowns... I'm going to say clown here. Again, I know there's going to be people listening now that don't necessarily hear a lot of what I've said at different times. I'm not saying that the police shooting was completely justified. It may have been, but it may not have been. The reason I'm calling these two clowns clowns is because they got into a scuffle with police. That's stupid. If the police pull you over and you have done nothing, you've done absolutely nothing, but for whatever reason, the police are ticked off and they're pulling you over, or they pull over when you're walking down the side of the road and they tell you, get down on your knees, put your hands behind your head, whatever they say, cooperate. Don't get into a scuffle with police. Don't push the police officer back in the car and make a move for his gun. Every time that someone goes for a police officer's gun, nothing good can come from it. Every time somebody goes after a police officer's gun, only bad is going to come from that. All right? I'm not saying that that means the police have a right to shoot you, or the police were justified in shooting Michael Brown, the 18-year-old that was shot outside of St. Louis. But I am saying that if you go for the police officer's gun, something bad is going to happen. All right? And we'll see if whether or not this is going to end up being a justified police shooting or not. I'm not even going to take a guess right now. I'm not going to place a bet, because it very well might not be a justified shooting. But what I want to talk about is all of this unrest. Yesterday, they had a rally in support of the family and the slain Michael Brown. And they had a candlelight vigil, and then the fit hit the shan, as Larry Elder likes to say, and the people, the black people there outside of St. Louis, have been going berserk, rioting and looting and assaulting people. A bunch of people have been arrested. They went to a Quick Mart or something, I forget what it's called, it's like a 7-Eleven. They go in there and loot the place and then set it on fire. They broke into a tire store and stole mag wheels, custom wheels. They went into a shoe store, of course, and looted sneakers. So in the name of Michael, in the memory of Michael Brown, these people are stealing stuff that belongs to other people. All right, they're burning down buildings in the name of Michael Brown. What kind of a protest is this? It's not a protest. It's not a rally. It's not a candlelight vigil. It's a reason to steal stuff. All right, we can go crazy now and steal stuff. We can take other people's stuff because we want it. And it's like some of these people are sitting there and have nothing going on, and this is their big opportunity to get some stuff that they can't get otherwise. Steal other people's stuff because they're acting out. And it has nothing whatsoever to do with whether or not the police were justified in shooting Michael Brown. Zero. Nothing. I want to read something to you that I saw this morning when I was reading a couple of articles off of Drudge. And this is so disgusting. But this is the way a lot of those people feel. Not just in St. Louis, but in any city where all the rioting goes on. For whatever reason, when people feel that there hasn't been justice. No justice, no peace. In other words. So if we feel that there is injustice in some way, then we're going to steal stuff and burn down buildings and carry on with all this mayhem. And so the lesson I'm learning is, and I should just read this from stlouistoday.com. On the lot of the Quick Trip, that's the name of the store, the 7-Eleven type Quickie Mart, that was looted and burned on Sunday night, some men who said they had been there last night defended the damage as a response to injustice. DeAndre Smith, 30 years old, he's not a 19-year-old doofus, he's 30 years old, of the city of Ferguson, was happy to justify the looting when a reporter asked him about it on Monday. He said, quote, "This is exactly what is supposed to be happening when injustice is happening in your community. You have kids getting killed for nothing. So we're going to burn down the Quickie Mart." That's the response to injustice. And while we talked about this morning, my friend Steve said, well, the next question from the reporter should have been, well, what if it was you and your brother that owned the Quickie Mart? How would you feel about it then? And of course, the guy probably wouldn't give you a straight answer. The lesson to be learned is, if you feel that there is injustice, riot, loot, steal stuff, and burn down buildings. That is what African Americans believe in this country. Not all African Americans, but these inner city African Americans who believe that the Democratic Party is their only hope and that conservatives and the Tea Party are against them. So they believe if there is injustice, we got to burn down the neighborhood. Oh, God. Obama's America. This is Obama's America. I'm Jimmy Z, and I wish you well.